With Kirk Cousins out in Washington, Jets lead list of possible landing spots in 2018. The Redskins agreed to trade for Alex Smith, which means that Cousins has played his last game in D.C. Alex Smith joked Tuesday about the prospects of playing for the Browns, telling Dan Patrick, "They've got nowhere to go but up. 131 over the last 2 years just sounds amazing." Hours later, reports emerged that Smith would be traded to the Redskins, which means that Kirk Cousins' career in Washington will officially be kaput when the trade is finalized on March 14, the first day of the new league year. Cousins, who was franchised the last 2 seasons, earned $43.9 million in 2016-17. If the Redskins had tagged him again, he would have been in line for a $34.5 million payday in 2018. Instead, the team decided Smith was the better, cheaper option, which means that Cousins will be elsewhere, a possibility he hinted at Tuesday. Is money a part of it? Sure, Cousins told PFT Live's Mike Florio about leaving Washington to play for another team. Is it the only thing? No. It is about winning, and that's what I want more than anything, so I'm going to be willing to make sacrifices or do what has to be done to make sure I'm in the best possible position to win, and that's what the focus is going to be. And with that said, here are 5 possible landing spots for Cousins, who suddenly becomes the most sought after soon-to-be free agent in the 2018 class. New York Jets. The Jets haven't had a franchise-type quarterback since Brett Favre spent 1 year in New York back in 2008. That team started 8-3 before losing 4 of 5 and missing the playoffs. Since then, Jets' starting quarterbacks have included Mark Sanchez, Kellen Clemens, Greg McElroy, Geno Smith, Michael Vick, Ryan Fitzpatrick, Bryce Petty and Josh McCown. The team also used a 2016 second-round pick on Christian Hackenberg, who hasn't seen a regular season snap in 2 full seasons. It's safe to say he isn't the answer. Now, next year, ever. Meanwhile, the Jets are coming off a back-to-back 5-11 seasons and the glaring hole at quarterback remains. The team has the 6th overall pick in the 2018 NFL Draft and according to Chris Tripasso's latest mock draft for KaputSports.com, University of Texas offensive tackle Connor Williams still makes a lot of sense. Especially if the off-season blueprint includes landing a franchise quarterback, and CBS Sports NFL insider Jason LaCanfora thinks the Jets are the favorites to land Cousins. Another selling point: Cousins is a big fan of new Jets offensive coordinator Jeremy Bates. "I actually met Jeremy when he was Jay Cutler's quarterback coach in Chicago," Cousins told Fan from Radio Row on Tuesday. "That was in the draft, coming out in 2012. And I really liked him then. I just think he's a good football mind. Everybody I've talked to who knows him loves him. I think it was a smart hire by the Jets, and wish him well in what he does." The Jets have $77.6 million in cap space in 2018, according to SportRack. Jacksonville Jaguars. You could make the case that the Jaguars were one player away from the Super Bowl, and that one player was the quarterback. "That would be a heavy dose of revisionist history," we wrote last week about why Blake Bortles' playoff performance was proof he deserved to remain in Jacksonville, even at $19.1 million for next season. But that was before the chance to land Cousins became a real possibility. But here's the question the Jaguars have to answer: is Cousins, who at 29 is 4 years older than Bortles, worth what will likely be a 5-year, $128 million contract with roughly $75 million guaranteed? Bortles will be compensated like a replacement-level quarterback because, well, that's what he is. But he's also not the reason the Jaguars came up short against the Patriots in the AFC Championship game. That said, Bortles is an exception to the rule. In today's NFL, teams typically don't make deep playoff runs without a legit franchise quarterback. And although Cousins had a mediocre season by his standards, He was among the league's best passers in 2015 and 2016, when he ranked 7th and 3rd, respectively, in total value among all quarterbacks. The Jags have $20.1 million in cap space in 2018, according to SportRack. Denver Broncos. Broncos general manager John Elway was front and center in Mobile last week eyeballing former Oklahoma quarterback Baker Mayfield. And while that's no guarantee that Denver will draft a quarterback with the 5th overall pick, it does point to a glaring need at the position after Trevor Siemian, Brock Osweiler and 2016 first-rounder Paxton Lynch were all, to varying degrees, huge disappointments last season. The trio was so bad, in fact, that it was unclear if first-year coach Vance Joseph would make it to year two. He did, and you can bet he won't let any of the quarterbacks who saw the field in 2017 decide his fate in 2018. Which brings us to Cousins, a proven commodity who was originally drafted by Mike Shanahan, the former Broncos coach who won two Super Bowls with Elway under center. Sporting News' Eric Elko wrote last week that the Broncos are front runners for Cousins' services, and that was days before the Redskins traded for Smith. We'll know for sure by mid-March. The Broncos have $24.7 million in cap space in 2018, according to SportRack. Buffalo Bills. If the Jaguars seemed like a quarterback away from the Super Bowl, that was legitimately the case for the Bills. Remember, this is the same outfit that thought so little of Tyrod Taylor that first-year coach Sean McDermott benched him in Week 11 for rookie Nathan Peterman, who promptly threw 5 interceptions in 30 minutes. McDermott had no choice but to reinsert Taylor, who started the rest of the season. But his lackluster performance in the playoffs reinforced the idea that the Bills, who returned to the postseason for the first time since 1999, needed a franchise quarterback and that it would be at the top of the offseason to-do list. Buffalo has playmakers in LeSean McCoy, Zay Jones, Kelvin Benjamin, and Charles Clay, and Cousins would add some much-needed balance to a one-dimensional offense. The Bills have $30.9 million in cap space in 2018, according to SportRack. Cleveland Browns. Earlier this month, the MMQB.com's Albert Breer said that Cousins would seriously consider playing for the Browns, an outfit that went 0-16 this season and is 1-31 in Hugh Jackson's 2 seasons as coach. Thanks to a combination of on-field and front-office futility, the Browns have the 1st and 4th pick in the 2018 NFL Draft after passing on Carson Wentz in 2016 and Deshaun Watson last spring. In the most recent kaputsports.com mock draft, Chris Trapasso has Cleveland taking USC quarterback Sam Darnold 1st overall and running back Saquon Barkley 3 picks later. That changes should the Browns land Cousins. And while that seems decidedly unlikely for several reasons, Breer noted at the time that the team would consider going all in on both veteran and rookie quarterbacks. Cousins would also be the consolation prize for missing out on Smith. According to reports, the Browns tried to trade for Smith before the Redskins pulled the trigger. One enormous stumbling block is that Cousins has made it clear that he wants to go to a winner and would even be willing to sacrifice money to make it happen. And while the Jets and Broncos both had losing seasons, recent history suggests they're much more likely to turn things around before the Browns come close to sniffing .500. Ultimately, this decision going forward is about winning games, Cousins told the Jim Rome show on Tuesday hours before news of the trade leaked. I've had an opportunity to earn a good living playing football, so I want to go win. That can be Washington. It really can. It's what I'll be remembered for. That's what's going to matter. The Browns have $102.6 million in cap space in 2018, according to SportRack.